Assetto Corsa Competition currently stands at version 1.0.8 as of yesterday. So, Kunos have released yet another big update, which has some quite significant changes in it. But not only that, they also announced a DLC, which includes several new tracks. What these significant changes are, and which tracks will be added to the game, will be further clarified in this video, so stay tuned. Since the list of changes in the new update is huge, we will only be going over the changes that have the most impact or are the most interesting in terms of the gameplay. First of all, there is a new pit lane logic. The pit lane now opens after the leader has completed his first lap, though there is still a possibility to come into the pits, but there will be no pit crew waiting for you, so don't do that. Secondly, Kunos added automatic driver swaps, so there should be no more confusion on how to change the driver, since with this option enabled, the game will automatically just put in the next person in line into the car. To get the full benefits of this option, it has to be enabled in the MFD first. The next feature is arguably the most impactful of all the new changes in the update. If a track is wet and there is standing water, the water will now influence the aerodynamics of your car. This is achieved by actually simulating the water which is on the track surface and effectively makes the track higher, so to say. In order to not lose most of your downforce, you can simply just raise your ride height about 5 mm and you should be good to go. Naturally, I also did some testing in the rain and it seems as if these aerodynamic instabilities come at random times. If you drive through a puddle or anything similar, for example. This does not mean, however, that you can just leave your car without adjusting for the standing water and be fine. Overall, the aerodynamics of your car will constantly be worse if you don't adjust the ride height correctly. But there are some spikes in the loss of downforce when you drive through a puddle, for example, as I mentioned before. Now, the last point regarding the update I want to focus on is that the racecraft rating was reset, but on their blog, Kunos explicitly mentioned that the old value will be remembered. So, you probably will get more RC faster to the point where new RC is higher than your old RC. And hand in hand with the RC change comes a safety rating change, where it will be now harder to get a higher rating. So, a small drop in everyone's safety rating has to be expected. That was it with the most important things added in this update, and if you are interested in reading through all the patch notes, I will leave you a link in the description. But this week, not only the update happened, Kunos also made an announcement, which casts a shadow on all the new things they added in this update. The Intercontinental GT pack will come to Assetto Corsa Competition. Now, before you ask yourself what this even is and why it is important, let me make it short for you. Basically, three of the most iconic racetracks in the world are coming to ACC. These tracks are the WeatherTech Raceway Laguna Seca, which is located in the USA, the iconic F1 circuit from Japan that goes by the name of Suzuka, and also a track from Australia where endurance races happen on a regular basis. And I'm of course talking about the Mount Panorama circuit in Bathurst. Hopefully it isn't upside down though. Oh yeah, and before I completely forget about it, there's also a fourth track coming, which is located in South Africa. And its name is as unpronounceable as Le Castillet. And because I will probably have a stroke while trying to read its name, I will just put it on screen for you. It is called Qualamic Grand Prix Circuit or something like that, and to be honest, its layout looks far better than its name is pronounced correctly, which is quite promising. Unfortunately, there is no set release date for this DLC, and also no known price yet. The only statement regarding the DLC just goes by the classic coming soon message. In the end, I am quite hyped for this DLC and really looking forward to testing the new tracks. Now, if you enjoyed this video and could take something with you, you could consider subscribing to this channel for more sim racing content. And with that said, I will catch you in the next one. Cheers!